honest, I have done my best to stay clear of Geed. He wears dishonesty about himself like a cloak, and seeks only to better his situation by preying on the misfortunes of others.
Good day.
Traveled east, over the mountains and into the vast deserts of broken lands. As the days passed, my companion told me of himself, that he had once been a great warrior, and that a dark and secret burden now weighed heavily upon him. We traveled for an eternity across that barren wasteland. How long ago? I couldn't say. And always, a dark cloud seemed to follow us just over the horizon. Finally, the journey ended. We climbed the last bridge. There below us lay our destination. The shining jewel, Root Lane, with a great sea beyond. We made camp that last night. Perhaps it was the warm desert wind or the sound of the ocean, but for the first time in many weeks, I slept. However, the dreams returned, but these were clearly not my own. I beheld a vision of a great man, the mage Talrasha. You were there too, Tyriel. I remember seeing you in my dream. His brethren had cornered a great demon, Bale, Lord of Destruction, who had been set loose upon the world. They attempted to imprison the demon within a sacred stone. Yet when their attempts failed, Talrasha selflessly volunteered to contain the demon within himself, completing the prison. He instructed his brethren to bind him within a tomb buried under the sand, there to wrestle with the demon for all eternity. The next morning, we walked over the hill toward Loot Gulane. I had no idea then of the horrors that were in store for me there.
Greetings, honored traveler. I am Jaren, Lord of Loot Gulane. And I bid you welcome to my fair port city. I'm glad to know that once again, caravans are free to travel through the Western Pass. For some time now, we have been under siege by an evil power that I cannot identify. Strange, it all began when a dark wanderer came this way, looking for the tomb of Talrasha. No one knows exactly where Talrasha, Keeper of Bale, is entombed, but it is certain to be far out in the desert. Greetings, honored traveler. I am Jaren, Lord of Loot Gulane, and I bid you welcome to my fair port city. I'm glad to know that once again, caravans are free to travel through the Western Pass. For some time now, we have been under siege by an evil power that I cannot identify. strange. It all began when a dark wanderer came this way, looking for the tomb of Talrasha. No one knows exactly where Talrasha, Keeper of Baal, is entombed, but it is certain to be far out in the desert. Now my people whisper tales of the dead rising from their tombs, and horrible creatures lurking amongst the moonlit dunes. Even I have witnessed things which I cannot explain. I've ordered the port closed and all trade ships moored until I am sure that my city is safe. Atma, the tavern keeper, has an important mission for you. Go see her immediately. You'll find her on the other side of town. Now I must return to the palace. I apologize, but I can't invite you in. Things are rather a mess right now. For trade in magic and the like, see Drognin or Lysander. Drognin is the wisest man I know, without equal in magic and ancient lore. Poor Lysander is nearly deaf, but he's a reliable potion chemist. For travel back west, see Wariv, whom you already know. Our own Farah is a fine and honest armorer, and she can heal wounds as well. Elzix is the innkeeper, and may also have some items to trade. Graze, the mercenary captain I hired to secure the gates of Lut Golain, keeps order in town as well. There are others here too. I'm sure you'll meet most of them. Just look around. The woman Atma may have some useful gossip for you. She can always be found near her public house.
Out of the way.
Trust you, And you may be as shifty as that pack rat Elzix who runs the inn. But if you need a potion, though, I suppose I can make you one. For a price, of course. How do I know I can... the sweetest desert flower. That's Atma. Even my strongest brood can't bring back her family, though.
I know much about the ancient religions. I was trained as a paladin of Zakharum in the Eastern Koras Temple many years ago.
Expect this of you, but if you want to help me, I would be grateful. In the sewers below our city, there lurks a horrid creature that hungers for human flesh. The creature has killed many, including my son, my husband. If you destroy it, I will reward you. Please, be careful, though. That beast has taken enough from us already. The sewer entrance is through the trapdoor, just up the street. The creature makes its lair in the tunnels beneath the city. He butchered my husband and son.
I've heard that you are responsible for banishing Undariel back to the Burning Hills. I'm impressed, stranger. That couldn't have been easy. I've heard that you are responsible for banishing Undariel back to the Burning Hells. I'm impressed, stranger. That couldn't have been easy. My name is Drognin, and I know what you're up against, my friend. You ought to look over my inventory of items for trade.
This wasteland has to offer. I've personally found some of that devil's victims washed up out of the sewer. Often they are missing limbs or a head, and their bodies have always been skinned. At first, the creature raided the town at night. That's how Atma lost her family. Now we've got her barricaded in the sewers. You're safe up here on the surface, but every now and again, some fool wants to be a hero and heads down to the waste tunnels with a pig sticker. Drognan's a mystery to me. Then again, I never did trust mages much.
Sturdy adventurer. You know, I used to be quite the scoundrel in my day. I led the fiercest group of bandits who ever terrorized these sands. Nowadays, I run this here inn and pretty much stay out of trouble. My days of adventuring are behind me. I hear that the creature kills his victims in order to hack off their limbs. I guess that makes me a less likely candidate, eh? We've all fared well under Jaren's leadership. The town has remained safe throughout this whole mess. And yet, the lad still seems very upset about something.
Yeah. Good day. The Herodric mummies were created to protect the tombs, but Rodimont is far from his burial chamber. Given the aberrations that have been witnessed lately, it comes as no surprise that even the ancient guardian spells have begun to unravel. Be wary of this as you venture farther into the desert. Hello. to see you.
Good day.
Thank you. Blessings to you.
They say that the taste of vengeance is bittersweet, but I find it to my liking. In addition to my undying gratitude, I have spoken on your behalf with the rest of the townspeople. The merchants have agreed to show their gratitude by offering their wares and services at lower rates. Oh, Jaren wants to see you too. You'll find him in front of the palace. They say that Geglash may seem like a sot, but he's a brave man. All this.
Drognan and I have concluded that the Dark Wanderer who passed through here recently was Diablo himself, Drognan believes that Diablo is searching the desert for the secret tomb where the great Horadric mage, Talrasha, keeps Bale imprisoned. You must find Diablo and put an end to the terrible evil that has fallen upon our city. Drognan is wise and is sure to have some helpful advice for you as to how Talrasha's tomb may be found. It may take you quite some time to find the tomb. May you be ready when you do. Yes? You seem very capable, but no offense is intended when I say that I must choose my confidants carefully. It wouldn't do to have rumors sending everyone into a panic. It is well known that there are 7 great Horadric tombs hidden beneath the sands in the furthest reaches of the desert. One of them surely must be Talrasha's prison. You must explore each of the tombs to find Talrasha's exact location. Of course, Diablo is searching for the tomb as well. No one can guess as to what terrors he has unleashed in his search.
Scroll! What a fortunate turn of events! As the last living Horadrim, I alone have knowledge of its meaning. Now, to read the Horadric runes it bears. The Horadric mages, after binding Bale within Talrasha, magically sealed off his burial chamber from the mortal realm. Those same mages also crafted fearsome Herodric staves and imbued them with the special power to open the chamber's hidden door. After nearly losing one to the thievery of a rogue sorcerer, they divided all the Herodric staves into two parts, wooden shaft and metal headpiece, hiding them separately to safeguard them. The Herodrum foresaw our current plight and designed the hiding places to reveal themselves to worthy heroes like you. Stay a while and listen. Ah, the lost Herodric scroll! What a fortunate turn of events! As the last living Herodrum, I alone have knowledge of its meaning. Now, to read the Herodrum.
Chose to embody the spirit of Baal, he knew his doom was to wrestle eternally against the will of the greater evil. Look around you and ask yourself, has the battle been won or lost?
Ask and learn.